Welcome back today to 365 Days of Kindness. This is a project where I'm reading these stories again, putting them on the internet so my girls will have them forever. My youngest turns 9 this year, and we're on year 3 of reading these books every day. So this one was from 2022. This was 2023. And then we have a new Act of Kindness book for 2024. I've been meaning to do this for a long time. I just kind of forgot, and I kept waiting for January 1st because I wanted to start over, you know, obviously on the 1st of January. So we're reading a passage from this book and a passage from this book each day, uploading the same thing to YouTube and Facebook. That way my girls can always go back and read or hear me read these lessons for maybe one day when they're older and they have kids or grandkids or great-great-grandkids. So once it's out there on the internet, it's forever. So that is my part doing this. If you have children and you want them to hear these messages, that is why I'm putting it out here as well publicly. If you're watching on YouTube, you can hit the subscribe button for so you get it, you know, get it every day. There is a playlist, so it will be listed in chronological order. If you're watching on Facebook, you can hit that follow button. This profile is a public profile. And either one of those, hit that like button so it pumps it up in the algorithm. And let's get started. So today is January 7th, so this is the 7th day of 365 days. We're starting up here. Feeling good. We have thought on your loving kindness, O God. Psalms 48 and 9. Jessica was the kind of person everyone loved to be around. She was fun and funny and kind. She always wore a smile and gave out hugs like they were Skittles. Being around Jessica made people feel good. If you've ever had a friend like that, you come away feeling encouraged and happy. Spending time with God does exactly the same thing. Thinking about who He is makes you feel loved and special. That's because He shows mercy, is kind, does not become angry quickly, and has great love. In fact, His love reaches all the way up to heaven. His faithfulness stretches up to the sky. Close your eyes, breathe in deep, and think about this. God's love for you doesn't fail. It will never stop, but go on and on and on and on. How does that make you feel? Dear God, your love reaches to heaven. Your faithfulness stretches up to the sky. You never change. You never stop loving. Thank you for loving me. Amen. I forgot to mention, this book each day ends with a prayer. So when I get to this part, if you want to pray as I read it to you, that is absolutely fine with me. And here is day 7 of 365 days of kindness. Loyalty. The Lord bless you, my daughter, he replied. This kindness is greater than that which you showed earlier. You have not run after the young men, rather rich or poor. Ruth 3:10. Ruth was able to make choices about her life. She did not have to travel with Naomi back to her homeland. She could have chosen to stay at home in her own community. She didn't have to marry Boaz, but she chose goodness and helped Naomi over her own needs. In the end, she was blessed. Her loyal choices made her a woman of grace and dignity. When you are faced with choices, it is only natural to think of yourself and what the different options will mean for you. In those times, remember to think about how your choices might affect those around you. You can influence for good and for bad. It is your choice. Choose wisely. And your act of kindness for January 7th is say something kind to someone in your family. I hope you guys get something out of what I'm doing. If you like what I'm doing, hit that like button. Drop some comments down below, and I'll see you guys tomorrow.